Hey, it's Jay, and I'm here with Adrienne today, who is a professional cleaner. She has her own business called Good to Be Home Cleaning Services, and she's a professional in sanitizing homes. It's a time where a lot of people are concerned and want to make sure they're doing the right things for their home.
That's the most request from our customers right now, and we feel like that's how we can help the most if we keep their house virus-free and just do a professional sanitizing on it.
You've found a few products that are a little safer than just using straight bleach in food areas and that kind of thing,
yes.
But still being able to take care of 99.9% of the viruses.
Yes, that's right.
We're gonna go through a few products that you can make at home if you're running low on chemicals from the store. You can use some of the things in your own home.
That's what we are gonna do today.
Awesome.
I'm gonna show you guys how to make your own products at home.
Can you show us like what you generally use? Like, let's say it's not a crisis time and all the products are available on the shelf. What kind of products are you using?
What we have here today, these are the simple Clorox products and also Lysol. We love using it because it kills 99.9% of germs and virus. Really safe to use around the house because all of these are bleach free. But because we are running a little short on the stores in supplies, we are going to demonstrate what we can mix together.
Okay, so if you have these, then awesome, but what if you don't? So you're gonna show us a few things that'll help us if we can't find these in the store.
Yes, oh, absolutely. I already mixed together water and a quarter of a cup of vinegar and just a little bit of Dawn soap. If you mix these together, you can cleanse off any kind of surfaces. This one breaks down organic materials.
So basically a product like this is you're going to use this to spray down and just kind of clean away all the, like you said, the grime, but like really the organic material from our fingerprints and this and that.
Yes.
That'll break down some of the stuff. Is this going to kill the virus?
It's not going to kill all the viruses. It's going to be effective, of course, but then you have to use different solutions also, what you can find at home, because these are not going to be available. So we're just going to put this on the side right
okay.
now and then focus yeah. on what to use when you are running out of the supplies. This is from old times. It's like a laundry booster,
okay,
but as simple washing soda. You can mix together with water. It's like quarter of a cup or so, because we have a small bottle. You can
okay.
mix that together with water. And
should I just fill this up with some water?
Yes.
Okay. I've got a handy sink right here.
I really hope I can do that.
So this is a little less than a quarter cup.
Yeah.
Would you recommend both of these or just one or the other?
One or the other.
Yeah.
But then you have to use hydrogen peroxide.
Okay.
Just put it on the dry clothes. We do have some.
Here's some hydrogen peroxide.
Yes. After you use this one to clean the surfaces
uh-huh.
or door handle, then you can use the product. Please do not mix together. It's gonna be a volcano.
It'll be a science
yes,
experiment,
it's gonna be a
which
science
we actually
project.
Like on this channel. So, so this is what's gonna kill the virus.
Yes.
Why don't we try some of this out, and
okay.
you can demonstrate how to use them effectively.
Okay. Just spray on any kind of surfaces. Just a couple of drops on the dry cleaning clothes, and we should leave this on for a few minutes actually, 5 to 10 minutes, and if it's still not dried, because it could be like really drying off by itself, you can just easily wipe it off. To use the cleaning product, you can use it on the door handles or the refrigerator handle actually. Don't spray this directly on the surface, instead of just spray on the cleaning cloth.
touched by many, many hands.
Touched by the kids often.
Yes. And you are already in the house and you touched everything basically. And you want to make sure you clean your handles.
And in this case, you're using the soap and vinegar solution as well?
Yes. Okay. Yes, the first, that's what we use. And when it's dried out, we can use the hydrogen peroxide. And it's just a suggestion when you are walking barefoot in your own home and you're carrying also germs on your shoes, maybe you should have just leave your shoes outside instead of walking into your house.
What about like packages and, you know, from like Amazon and that kind of stuff?
Yes, Lysol spray does the best job, and you can just easily spray through on your grocery bags before you are entering in the house with the bags, or also packages before you are bringing into your safe home, which is already been sanitized.
All right, so we're back here at the countertop and it looks really nice. It looks like shiny. Do we need to do anything further at this point?
No, your countertop is free to touch.
Okay, yeah.
With your clean hand.
So the hydrogen peroxide just kind of evaporates off, and the reason we'd wait 5 to 7 minutes is just to let it disinfect for that time before, you don't want to introduce anything else, right?
Like, yes.
Definitely don't want to put grocery bags on top of it right after you've sanitized it.
No.
You're cringing right now.
Yeah, I'm done. I don't even want to touch that with gloves. So
yeah.
So it's really nice and clean and safe. Anytime when you have a sick kid at home and you want to sanitize fabrics, we just found a new product from Clorox, which is amazing. And we can use this on any kind of textiles or fabric material. You can just spray that through even on your fabric couch.
Well, thank you so much.
Oh, yeah.
I really appreciate it. We just want everybody out there to stay safe, and we hope that this little video just helps people feel a little more comfortable trying to fight the battlefront in their homes. Adrienne's amazing. She has a big heart, and just really appreciate having her out today.
Thank you. Our pleasure.
2 days later.
Hey, it's a couple days later and my son is napping right now, so I just decided to grab a lot of the toys that he uses a lot, and I'm going to sanitize them the way that Adrienne showed us the other day. Also our household remotes and cell phones. There's a few items, the remotes, the cell phone. Actually, the cell phone could probably get wet, but it's okay. We're gonna do it differently. And then some of his books that he often uses along the same lines is I'm gonna take some vinegar, get it wet just a little bit, put a little bit of soap, and now I have like a nice microfiber cloth that I can just wipe everything down with. So instead of getting everything completely saturated, I'm just gonna wipe it down with this vinegar soap solution. And then I just have a dry microfiber cloth, and I'm just gonna wipe everything away. The next step is to actually sanitize. So I happen to have this Lysol with hydrogen peroxide. If you don't have that, you can just use straight up hydrogen peroxide like we showed earlier in the video. So I'm wearing disposable nitrile gloves that will protect my hands, even though this is a fairly harmless product. I'm gonna let this sit for about 10 minutes and then we'll wipe everything down one more time and we'll be good to go.
Later.
It's actually been well over 10 minutes and now we'll just take a dry microfiber, clean microfiber cloth, and I'm just gonna wipe everything down. Here's the truck. Camera. Okie dokie. Alright, now I'll just throw these microfiber cloths and towels right in the wash. You wanna go play?